Okay, so today we'll be seeing one more communication technology that is used for in IoT. So in the last lecture we have seen the RFID, that is radio frequency identification technology, and then we have seen Bluetooth. In Bluetooth, actually we have seen two types of Bluetooth. One is a classic Bluetooth and the second one is the Bluetooth low energy, that is BLE, which is also said to be as a Bluetooth 4.0. In today's lecture, we are going to see the new technology, or I could say that you might have heard about that technology. Quite a similar technology that has been used here is the new one called as a Zigbee. So you might have heard about this Zigbee technology. So today we are going to see this Zigbee. It is the technology standard designed for control and sensor network, right? It is designed for control and sensor networks. It is based on IEEE 802.15.4. This is to be remembered as it is the IEEE standard which it follows. Later on, we'll see that how it follows the standard set by the IEEE 802.15.4. This was created by Zigbee Alliance. So henceforth, the name is given as a Zigbee. It operates in PAN and device-to-device network. PAN means personal area network. It's like around about 30 feet, the network is there. Beyond 30 feet, it will not work. Within 30 feet, all the computers are connected with each other and they coordinate with each other. They operate in PAN, and hence we say it to be as an operating PAN. It provides the connectivity between small packet devices. Yes, it provides the connectivity between small packet devices. Small packet devices. It can control light switches, thermostats, etc. It is a standard that defines a set of communication protocol for low data rate, short range wireless networking. So actually it follows the communication protocol, most important. Second, it is having a low data rate. Third, it's having a shorter range. And fourth, it is a wireless networking, so without wire. So it will operate in this way. Zigbee-based devices operates on mostly 868 megahertz to 915 megahertz and 2.4 gigahertz frequency band. The maximum data rate is about 250 kbps. Zigbee is mainly targeted for battery-powered applications where there is low data rate, low cost, and long battery life are the main requirements. So whenever there is a, you can use this wireless technology. Whenever you are having the requirement such as low battery, means battery powered applications, then low data rate, low cost, and having a long battery life. Obviously, when it is been operating on a low power, the battery life will be more. So whenever your most important priority is about the battery life, and then you can use this Zigbee because it is having a low power applications. It can be used for low power applications. Zigbee devices pair most of the time in power saving modes. Henceforth, it is in a sleep mode. So we have already seen what is sleep mode. So there are three modes: run mode, sleep mode, and deep sleep mode. So Zigbee operates in a sleep mode. So some of the systems are operating, whereas rest are in the sleeping mode. Why it is in sleeping mode? Because we want to save power. It goes in a power saving mode. And that's why, because of which it has a long battery life. In many application devices, it has a duty cycle of less than 1% to ensure that maximum battery life is there. So yet another important concept is that if you want to increase more battery life, ensure more battery life, then you can reduce the duty cycle to about 1%. Now we can compare here the technologies, different technologies that have been reused here, and the comparison can be mostly on two parameters. One is what is the data rate, And second is, what is the typical range of that data? What is the typical range of that technology? These are the two factors that comes into the picture. And these two factors decides actually whether which kind of application to be preferred, whether we should go for a Zigbee, whether we should go for RFID, whether we should go for Bluetooth or Bluetooth low energy. So depending upon these two parameters, you're going to decide which kind of technology to be preferred. If we go for Zigbee, the data rate is around about 20 to 50 kbps, whereas the range is 10 to 100 meters. Whereas in case of Bluetooth, 1 to 3 mbps, and typical range is 2 to 10 meter. And Bluetooth low energy is in 0.3 mbps and 2 to 10 meters. So as compared to all these things, you can see that Zigbee is having typically more range, distance covered, and as well as the data rate is also high. So depending upon the requirement, what is your requirement of the whatever the requirement is there of the application, whatever application you're developing and what is its requirement, mainly that decides which kind of technology to be preferred. Now this is very important to see whether which kind of device type is to be used. See, the device type is very important to understand, because you're going to understand the whole Zigbee concept with the help of these device types. So mostly there are two Zigbee device types. The first one is full function device, and the second is the reduced function devices. Now let us understand what this FFD and RFD means, because that is going to help you to understand about the Zigbee architecture, how it works, and the topologies that are used in Zigbee. So the first one is a full function device, and the second one is a reduced function device. So as far as the full function devices is concerned, it is capable of performing all the duties that are described by IEEE 802.15.4 standard, and it can accept any role in the network. So FFD is a full function device. FFD can operate in three modes: a PAN coordinator, a coordinator, or a device. So it can operate in a three mode, that is called as the full function device. The second one is RFD, that is reduced function device. It has limited capabilities as compared to FFD. That is, FFD can communicate with any device. Okay. अगर उसको कम्युनिकेट करना है एक डिवाइस से दूसरे डिवाइस में, तो एफ एफ डी कैन कम्युनिकेट विद एनी डिवाइसेस, बट आर एफ डी कैन कम्युनिकेट विद ओनली एफ एफ डीज. सो जितने एफ एफ डीज है फुल फंक्शन डिवाइस, उन्हीं के साथ आर एफ डी कम्युनिकेट कर सकता है. राइट, सी देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ जिगबी डिवाइसेस. वन इज अ फुल फंक्शन डिवाइस, द सेकेंड वन इज रिड्यूस फंक्शन डिवाइस. फुल फंक्शन डिवाइस कैन परफॉर्म एनी रोल इन द नेटवर्क दैट इज असाइन टू इट. But as far as reduced function device is concerned, it can communicate with only FFD, whereas the FFDs can communicate with any devices that are available. These are the two most important differences. Power and memory required for RFD is less as compared to FFD. As FFD has to fully concentrate on each and every devices, henceforth the memory and power requirement will be more as compared to the RFD. A network must include at least one FFD. एक एफ एफ डी कम से कम होना चाहिए ऑपरेटिंग एज अ पर्सनल पैन कोऑर्डिनेटर. सो एक एफ एफ डी कम से कम होना चाहिए, और वो पैन कोऑर्डिनेटर बोल के काम करना चाहिए, यानी कि वो सारा जो रोल है उसका एज अ पैन कोऑर्डिनेटर कोऑर्डिनेट करने का, वो एफ एफ डी करेगा. और हर नेटवर्क में, कोई भी टोपोलॉजी हो, कोई भी नेटवर्किंग हो, उसमें कम से कम एक एफ एफ डी होना जरूरी है. नाउ लेट अस सी टोपोलॉजीज. So these topologies, you might be having a network topologies. You have seen these kind of topologies mostly in the communication network. So in topologies here, there are three types of topologies that are available. One is a star topology. Second is mesh topology. And third one is a cluster topology. First two topologies are very important. Cluster topology, I am additionally teaching you as it is needed actually. Once you understand star and mesh, cluster can be easily understood. So FFD and RFD is needed to learn these topologies. So let us go with the first topology called as star topology. So you can see that the dark circle is the pan coordinator. So obviously we should have a pan coordinator. Then the gray color circle is nothing but full function device, that is FFT. And third one is reduced function device called as RFD, which is completely white. So as we know, what is the rule? The rule is that FFD can be communicating with any devices, but the RFD can communicate with only FFD. So RFD can communicate with only FFD. You can see that there is a pan coordinator in between, and the FFD is communicating with the pan coordinator, right? Because the RFD is to be communicated with only FFT. This is what the star topology says. So in star topology, communication is established between devices and a single central controller called as pan coordinator. So communication is established between the devices and there is a single central controller called as pan. After an FFD is activated for the first time, that is full function device, it may establish its own network and become a pan coordinator. Ek bar FFD ko activate kar do, तो वो खुद ब खुद पैन कोऑर्डिनेटर बन जाएगा। ईच स्टार नेटवर्क चूज अ पैन आइडेंटिफायर व्हिच इज नॉट करेंटली यूज्ड बाय एनी अदर नेटवर्क विद इन द रेडियो स्फीयर ऑफ द इन्फ्लुएंस। दिस अलाउज ईच स्टार नेटवर्क टू ऑपरेट इंडिपेंडेंटली। सबसे पहले उनको पैन आइडेंटिफाई करना पड़ता है, फिर बाकी का काम वो कर सकते हैं। द पैन कोऑर्डिनेटर मे बी पावर्ड बाय मेन्स व्हाइल द डिवाइसेस विल मोस्ट लाइकली टू बी बैटरी ऑपरेटेड। सो बाकी के सब बैटरी ऑपरेटेड रहेंगे, लेकिन जो पैन कोऑर्डिनेटर है उसको पावर देना जरूरी है मेन से, जिसको सब कुछ कनेक्टेड है। एप्लीकेशन दैट बेनिफिट्स फ्रॉम दिस टोपोलॉजी आर होम ऑटोमेशन, पर्सनल कंप्यूटर पेरिफेरल्स, टॉयज एंड गेम्स। सो स्टार टोपोलॉजी इनमें यूज हो सकती है, होम ऑटोमेशन के अंदर, पर्सनल कंप्यूटर पेरिफेरल्स के अंदर, टॉयज में और गेम्स में, इन सब में स्टार टोपोलॉजी का इस्तेमाल हो सकता है। अभी दूसरा है मैश टोपोलॉजी। सो अगेन वी हैव टू सी दैट देर इज अ वन पैन कोऑर्डिनेटर, देन पैन कोऑर्डिनेटर मींस इट विल बी योर एफएफटी, देन द आरएफडीज, आरएफडी विल बी कम्युनिकेटिंग विद एफएफटीज, एंड द आरएफडी विल बी कम्युनिकेटिंग विद द एफएफटी। सो इन दिस वे हियर पीयर टू पीयर टोपोलॉजी और वी सेड टू बी एज अ मैश टोपोलॉजी डायग्राम इज कंसर्न। Now what happens in mesh? In peer-to-peer topology too, there is one PAN coordinator. So obviously you can see that there is one PAN coordinator. Any device can communicate with other device as long as they are in range of one another. So कोई भी device एक दूसरे से connect हो सकता है, बल्कि mostly उसका important है कि वो range में होना चाहिए. Thus a peer-to-peer network can be ad hoc, unfixed, self-organizing or self-healing. एडॉक यानी कि अनफिक्स्ड, यानी कि एक ही जगह पर नहीं रखा होगा, उसको थोड़ा हिला सकते हैं आप। सेल्फ ऑर्गेनाइजिंग यानी कि वो खुद सब ऑर्गेनाइज हुआ है, और सेल्फ हीलिंग यानी कि वो खुद ठीक कर सकता है सबको। सो ऐसे पीयर टू पीयर नेटवर्क को हम मेश टोपोलॉजी बोलते हैं। पीयर टू पीयर टोपोलॉजी अलाउज मल्टीपल हॉप्स टू रूट मैसेज फ्रॉम वन डिवाइस टू एनी अदर डिवाइस इन द नेटवर्क। इट कैन प्रोवाइड रिलायबिलिटी बाय मल्टीपाथ routing. So this topology allows the multi-hop to route the message from one device to the other device in the network. Applications such as industrial control and monitoring, wireless sensor networks and assets and inventory tracking would benefit from such type of topology. So किसके लिए काम में आ सकता है या किस जगह पर इस्तेमाल हो सकता है, तो वो हो सकता है इंडस्ट्रियल कंट्रोल में, यानी कि कंट्रोलिंग करने के लिए, मॉनिटरिंग करने के लिए। उसके बाद वायरलेस सेंसर नेटवर्क में यूज हो सकता है, एज वेल एज इन्वेंटरी ट्रैकिंग में यूज हो सकता है। सो दिस टाइप ऑफ टोपोलॉजी इज कॉल्ड एज मेश टोपोलॉजी। देन थर्ड वन इज अ क्लस्टर ट्री टोपोलॉजी। सो यू कैन सी दैट देयर इज अ नोड, डिफरेंट नोड्स, एंड दीज नोड्स आर कनेक्टेड लाइक ट्री, इट लुक्स लाइक अ ट्री। सो दिस इज अ क्लस्टर टोपोलॉजी। सो द क्लस्टर ट्री टोपोलॉजी इज अ स्पेशल केस ऑफ पीयर टू पीयर नेटवर्क in which most of the devices are FFDs. So this is the big difference between the other topologies and cluster topology. So isme zyada zyada full function devices zyada honge, most of the devices. Any of the FFDs can act as a coordinator and provide synchronization service to the other devices and coordinators. So ek bar wo FFDs sabse zyada honge to usme se ek FFD coordinator bolke kaam karega, और वो कोऑर्डिनेट करेगा। हावेवर ओनली वन ऑफ दीज कोऑर्डिनेटर विल बी अ पैन कोऑर्डिनेटर, बाकी के वो FFD बोल के ही काम करेंगे। सो इस केस में FFDs ज्यादा ज्यादा रहेंगे और उसमें से एक पैन कोऑर्डिनेटर होगा। द पैन कोऑर्डिनेटर फॉर्म्स द फर्स्ट क्लस्टर बाय एस्टैब्लिशिंग इटसेल्फ एज अ क्लस्टर हेड, ठीक है, विद अ क्लस्टर आइडेंटिफायर ऑफ जीरो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज CID, चूजिंग एन अनयूज्ड पैन आइडेंटिफायर। तो इसमें क्या होगा, पैन कोऑर्डिनेटर फॉर्म्स द फर्स्ट क्लस्टर बाय एस्टैब्लिशिंग इटसेल्फ एज अ क्लस्टर हेडर। सो सबसे पहले पैन कोऑर्डिनेटर एस्टैब्लिश करेगा एज अ क्लस्टर हेड बोल के, और बाद में वो आइडेंटिफाई करेगा दूसरे क्लस्टर्स को ताकि अनयूज्ड पैन आइडेंटिफायर को वो कोऑर्डिनेट कर सके। दी सी एल एच दैट इज अ क्लस्टर हेड ब्रॉडकास्ट बेकन्स फ्रेम्स टू द नेबरिंग डिवाइसेस। अ कैंडिडेट डिवाइस रिसीविंग अ बेकन फ्रेम मे रिक्वेस्ट टू ज्वाइन द नेटवर्क एट क्लस्टर हेड। सो दिस इज हाउ द क्लस्टर टोपोलॉजी वर्क्स आउट। द न्यूली ज्वाइंट डिवाइस विल एड द क्लस्टर हेड एज इट्स पैरेंट इन द नेबर लिस्ट एंड बिगेन ट्रांसमिटिंग पीरियोडिक बेकन्स सच दैट अदर कोऑर्डिनेट कैंडिडेट डिवाइसेस मे देन ज्वाइन द नेटवर्क एट दैट डिवाइस। Once the application or network requirements are met, the PAN coordinator may instruct a device to become a cluster head of a new cluster adjacent to be first. See, सीधी सी बात है कि नए डिवाइस को जिनको एंटर करना होगा वो न्यूली ज्वाइंट डिवाइसेस ऐड हो जाएंगे, उसमें से एक क्लस्टर हेड हो जाएगा और वो क्लस्टर हेड जो है वो नेबरिंग को डेटा ट्रांसफर कर सकता है। सो इट विल बी इन द नेबरिंग एंड इट विल ट्रांसफर द डेटा। In this way, the RFD may connect to the cluster tree network as a leaf node at the end of the branch. इस तरह से RFD बिल्कुल cluster tree network को connect कर सकता है, जैसे कि leaf की तरह, जैसे end of the branch. Branch के end में leaf जैसा होता है, वैसे RFD connect हो सकता है. The advantage of the cluster structure is increased coverage at the cost of increased message latency. सो ये हो गए आपके तीन टाइप्स। फर्स्ट इज द स्टार टोपोलॉजी, सेकंड इज द मैश टोपोलॉजी दैट इज कॉल्ड एज पीयर टू पीयर टोपोलॉजी, एंड द थर्ड वन इज द क्लस्टर टोपोलॉजी विच इज अ क्लस्टर ट्री टोपोलॉजी। देन कम्स द डेटा ट्रांसफर मोड। सो देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ डेटा ट्रांसफर मोड दैट अपीयर्स टू बी हियर, इज द डेटा ट्रांसफर फ्रॉम डिवाइस टू कोऑर्डिनेटर, एंड सेकेंड इज द डेटा ट्रांसफर फ्रॉम कोऑर्डिनेटर टू डिवाइस। सो कोऑर्डिनेटर टू डिवाइस, डिवाइस टू कोऑर्डिनेटर, इस तरह के दो किस्म के डेटा ट्रांसफर मेथड ZigBee में यूज हो सकते हैं। अभी अगर फर्स्ट देखें हम कि डेटा ट्रांसफर टू कोऑर्डिनेटर फ्रॉम द डिवाइस, यानी डिवाइस से कोऑर्डिनेटर की तरफ जाने वाला डेटा ट्रांसफर, तो क्या होगा। सो इसमें दो एंड से, एक है ZigBee कोऑर्डिनेटर और दूसरा है ZigBee एंड डिवाइस। सो व्हेन ZigBee एंड डिवाइस सेंड्स अ डेटा रिक्वेस्ट, At that time, ZigBee coordinator will acknowledge it by sending a bit. That is called as the data transfer to coordinator from a device. दूसरा है data transfer from coordinator to device. So इस केस में अगेन ZigBee coordinator होगा, ZigBee device and devices होंगे। ZigBee and device से data request आएगा, ZigBee coordinator उसको acknowledgement करेगा by sending a bit. Then ZigBee coordinator data भेजेगा और ZigBee एंड डिवाइस उसको एक्नॉलेज करेगा। इन दिस द डेटा ट्रांसफर बिटवीन द टू प्योर डिवाइसेस आर सेम एज द वन, जो पहले वाला है बिल्कुल उसी तरह से है, सिर्फ डेटा जब सेंड करते हैं, रिक्वेस्ट करना और डेटा सेंड करना और एक्नॉलेज करना, बस इतना ही फर्क है सेकेंड में, यानी डेटा ट्रांसफर फ्रॉम कोऑर्डिनेटर टू डिवाइस। नाउ दिस इज द ZigBee आर्किटेक्चर। सो ZigBee आर्किटेक्चर में देख सकते हैं आप फिजिक लेयर, दी मीडियम एक्सेस कंट्रोल लेयर दैट इज मैक लेयर, थर्ड वन इज अ नेटवर्क लेयर, एंड द फोर्थ वन इज एन एप्लीकेशन लेयर कॉल्ड एज APL। सो फिजिकल लेयर और एप्लीकेशन लेयर जो है ये किस तरह से काम करते हैं, वो जैसे स्टैंडर्ड सेट किया है IEEE 802.15.4 ने, वो इस हिसाब से काम करते हैं फिजिकल और मैक लेयर। वेर एज द नेटवर्क लेयर और एप्लीकेशन लेयर जो है वो काम करते हैं डिफाइंड स्टैंडर्ड से, यानी कि ZigBee स्पेसिफिकेशन के हिसाब से काम करेंगे, और नीचे वाले लेयर जो है वो IEEE 802.15.4 स्टैंडर्ड के हिसाब से काम करेंगे। सो इस तरह से ये चारों लेयर्स काम करेंगे, पहले दो ZigBee स्पेसिफिकेशन के हिसाब से और बाद में के दो IEEE 802.15.4 के हिसाब से. नाउ लेट अस सी दैट हाउ दिस ईच लेयर वर्क्स आउट. सो सबसे पहले हम देखेंगे कि फिजिकल लेयर, मैक लेयर ये कैसे काम करते हैं. द बॉटम टू लेयर्स आर डिफाइंड बाय IEEE 802.15.4 स्टैंडर्ड एंड डिफाइन द स्पेसिफिकेशन ऑफ फिजिकल एंड मैक लेयर. सो ऑब्वियसली फिजिकल एंड मैक लेयर को डिफाइन करने के लिए कौन डिफाइन कर रहा है, वही IEEE स्टैंडर्ड डिफाइन कर रहा है. देन ZigBee स्टैंडर्ड डिफाइन्स द नेटवर्किंग एप्लीकेशन एंड सिक्योरिटी लेयर ऑफ द प्रोटोकॉल्स एंड अडेप्ट 802.15.4 फिजिकल एंड मैक एज अ पार्ट ऑफ अ ZigBee प्रोटोकॉल. ओके, नाउ लेट अस सी दैट व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट लेयर एंड व्हाट इज द रोल ऑफ दैट फर्स्ट लेयर. सो फर्स्ट है फिजिकल लेयर, जिसको हम PHY भी बोलते हैं. इट इज बिट बाय बिट ट्रांसमिशन के लिए फिजिकल लेयर यूज होता है. सिंक्रोनाइज करता है डेटा सिंक्रोनाइजेशन. देन इलेक्ट्रिकल सिग्नल्स टू फिजिकल मीडिया इंटरफेस किया जाता है, इलेक्ट्रिकल टू फिजिकल मीडियम इंटरफेस. एंड इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशंस एट 868 मेगाहर्ट्ज, 915 मेगाहर्ट्ज एंड 2.4 गीगाहर्ट्ज के फ्रीक्वेंसी रेंज में वो काम करता है. सो फिजिकल लेयर मोस्टली इज अ बिट बाय बिट ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ द डेटा. नाउ सेकेंड इज द मैक, दैट इज इट इज अ सब पार्ट ऑफ अ डेटा लिंक लेयर. सो यहाँ देखोगे मैक सब पार्ट ऑफ अ डेटा लिंक लेयर. ओके, रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ पैकेट्स टू एंड फ्रॉम. सो यहाँ से आपका डेटा ब्रेकअप होता है पैकेट्स में और भेजा जाता है और रिसीव किया जाता है, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज मैक. नाउ थर्ड वन इज अ नेटवर्क. सो दिस इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ अ नेटवर्क, फॉरवर्डिंग द पैकेट फ्रॉम बेस्ट पाथ, असाइन 16-bit नेटवर्क एड्रेस एंड राउट नेटवर्क पैकेट. सो दीज आर द फंक्शंस ऑफ द नेटवर्क. Then APL, what is APL? You can see where is APL. Okay, APL is the top layer. So APL क्या करता है? It divides the section into APS, AO and ZO. What is APS? APS does a role of binding the tables, message forwarding, group address definition and management, extended address to 16-bit network address and fragmentation and reassembly of the packets. So these are the work that is carried out by APS, and this APS is nothing but the part of APL. What is APL? APL is nothing but it is the top branch that has been top layer that has been at the top of the layer. Then AO, that is the send and receive the data. ZDO, initialize APS and network layer, device discovery and determination. And then last one is a security service, that is by encrypting and decrypting the data you can provide the securities, and key distribution is also one of the feature of security services. Now this is the ZigBee packet structure. So packet, how the data is sent into the packet in form of packet, it is sent and it is received. So that ZigBee packet structure is given here. So you can see this, you have SHR, PHR, physical load, that is transmitted first and transmitted last. Then you can see MAC frame, which is having MHR and MFR. Then network frame, which is having NHR, and APS frame, which is having AHR, AUX, HDR, APS payload and MIC. Now we'll see, let us see one by one, what are these terminologies. So first is SHR. So you can see that the physical payload ke andar SHR hai. SHR is called a synchronization header. It is the start, it gives you the start bit, stop bit and parity bits. Start bit, stop bit and parity bits, that is called as SHR, which is nothing but synchronization header. Now PHR is the physical header. It gives you the payload length information, length ke bare mein dega PHR. Okay, uske baad aayega MHR, that is a MAC address, hai na. Address and security information dega MHR. Uske baad MFR aayega, jo ki transmitted last bit mein hai. MFR is called as the MAC footer. It contains 16-bit frame check sequence for verification. Then comes your network frame, jisme aata hai NHR. NHR is called as the network header. the network layer addressing and control information. So it is useful for network layer addressing and control information. Then comes AHR, jo ki APS frame mein hai. AHR is called as the APS header, application layer control information. Then comes AUX HDR, that is auxiliary HDR. So HDR is nothing but your auxiliary HDR. So yes, auxiliary HDR is nothing but security keys. Then comes MIC. MIC is nothing but message integrity code to detect unauthorized changes in the content of the message. So they are having their own roles, and these roles are done in order to have the packeting structure that is called as the ZigBee packet structure. Then comes ZigBee characteristics. So it is having a low cost, then low power consumption. This is the most important characteristics. It is having a low data rate kam hai thoda sa, short transmission range about 30 meter to 100 meter, then flexible protocol design suitable for many applications, then operating frequency from 686 to 915 megahertz, 2.4 gigahertz, that is the operating frequency. Support power saving and sleep mode. Obviously jab power saving mode hota hai to sleep mode mein hi jata hai. Then comes your data rate, which is up to 250 kbps. It follows IEEE 802.15.4 standard. This is to be remembered. It has a modulation technique it uses, like BPSK, that is a bipolar phase shift keying, ASK amplitude shift keying, and QPSK quadrature phase shift keying. Then topology, mostly it uses star and mesh. Then it is simple in construction, and it supports a large number of nodes, that is up to 64,000. This is the ZigBee characteristics. Now, what are the ZigBee limitations? So the ZigBee limitations are: route reconstruction is costly, latency is longer, then smaller packets send over the large network, and data rate is 250 kbps. Then comes your ZigBee applications. In industrial and commercial use, sensor automation control, then it can be used in personal healthcare, then diagnostic sensor, can be used in toys and games, then for portable education devices, usme bhi use hota hai aajkal, portable education devices kafi hai market mein. Then the home automation, wahan par bhi use ho sakta hai, everything to be automated using ZigBee technology. पीसी पेरिफेरल्स को कनेक्ट करने के लिए भी हो सकता है, यानी वायर ZigBee यू कैन कनेक्ट योर पेरिफेरल्स. देन द वायरलेस कीबोर्ड एंड जॉयस्टिक्स, एंड देन कंज्यूमर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स. दीज आर सम ऑफ द एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ ZigBee. सो लेट अस लिटिल बिट रिवाइज फ्रॉम स्टार्ट व्हाट वी हैव सीन इन ZigBee. ओके, सो ZigBee इज एन वायरलेस स्टैंडर्ड. It is based on, designed for control and sensor network. It is based on IEEE 802.15.4. It is created by the ZigBee Alliance. It operates in PAN and from device to device network. It provides the connectivity between small packet devices. Then it operates in 868 megahertz to 915 megahertz and 2.4 gigahertz frequency band. The maximum data rate is up to 250 kbps, which is a low data rate. Then as far as the difference is concerned, before giving to difference, one of the most important is that it is a low power, having a battery powered applications. So it is having a low data rate, low cost and long battery life. It is having a low power applications. Then if you see the difference between ZigBee, Bluetooth and BLE, we can see that the data rate of ZigBee is quite high, that 20 to 250 kbps, and a range of 10 to 100 meters, whereas in Bluetooth it is 1 to 3 mbps, 2 to 10 meters, and BLE is about 0.3 mbps, 2 to 10 meters. Then there are two types of device types we have seen. The first one is the FFT, that is nothing but full function device. and second one is a reduced function device, that is RFD. Full function device operates in three modes: span, coordinator, coordinator or device, and it works according to the duties assigned by IEEE 802.15.4, and it can accept any role in the network. Whereas RFD is concerned, RFD can communicate with only FFDs, whereas FFD can communicate with any other devices. Power and memory required of RFD is less. And it should be also clear that the network should have at least one FFD operating as a PAN coordinator. Then three types of topologies: star, mesh, and cluster. So this is a star topology having FFD. Here there are two FFDs, that is full function device, one PAN coordinator, and then there is a reduced function device, that is RFD, which is in white color. So this is the star topology. This is the mesh topology, peer-to-peer topology. And then this is the cluster tree topology. And so now data transfer method in ZigBee. So there are two types of data transfer method. One is two coordinator from the device and two device from the coordinator. So when data transfer takes place, two coordinator from the device, it is from ZigBee coordinator, ZigBee end device. ZigBee end device sends a data request to the ZigBee coordinator, which in turn send an acknowledgement to the ZigBee end device. Now, in case of data transfer method from coordinator to the devices, so ZigBee end device sends a data request to ZigBee coordinator, which is acknowledged by sending a bit. Then the ZigBee coordinator sends the data to the ZigBee end devices, and the acknowledgement is sent by the end devices. Then this is the ZigBee architecture. So it is having a four layer: physical layer, MAC layer are the two bottom layers, and network and API layer are the two top layers. The bottom layers are defined, work accordingly by the IEEE standards, whereas the upper two layer is defined in the ZigBee specification way. So you can see that the physical layer is useful for bit-to-bit by transmission. It has synchronized the data, and it can be used up to frequency of 868 megahertz, 915 megahertz, and 2.4 gigahertz. So this is the first physical layer. Second is your MAC layer. It's a sub-part of a data link layer. Hello?
Hello?
Huh? The MAC layer, the sub part of the data link layer, responsible for transmission of packets to and from. Then the third is the network layer. So you can see that there is a network layer. This network layer is for formation of network, forwarding packets from best path, assign 16-bit network address, route network packets. Then comes your APL, divides in APS and AO and ZDO. So APS is for binding tables. It is useful for message forwarding, group address definition and management, and extended address to 16-bit network address, fragmentation and reassembly of the packets. AO, send and receive data. ZDO, initialize APS and network layer, device discovery and determination. And security services, that is encryption and decryption, that is key distribution. So this is the ZigBee packet structure. So you can see that there are the transmitted first and transmitted last bit. In the initially, it is having SHR, PHR, then MAC frame, MHR, network frame, NHR, and APS frame is having the AHR, AUX HDR, APS payload, and MIC. So if you see that SHR is called synchronization header, PHR is a physical header, MHR is a MAC address, MFR is a MAC footer, NHR is a network header, AHR is APS header, then auxiliary header, HDR, and then MIC, that is a message integrity code to detect the unauthorized changes in the content of the message. This is the ZigBee characteristics. So low cost, low power consumption, low data rate, then short transmission range, that is 30 meter to 100 meter, flexible protocol design suitable for many applications, Then operating frequency is 688 to 915 megahertz or 252.4 gigahertz. Support power saving mode, data rate low 250 kbps. Then modulation BPSK, ASK and QPSK topology, star mesh, simple in construction and support large number of nodes. This is the ZigBee limitations. Route reconstruction is costly, latency is longer, smaller packets over larger network and data rate is 250 kbps. Then these are some of the applications using in industrial and commercial: sensor automation control, having a personal healthcare, and diagnostic sensors, toys and games, portable education devices, home automation, PC peripherals, mouse, keyboards, joystick, and consumer electronics. So these are some of the applications. So I hope that you have understood this. Is there any question? Is there any question? Hello? Is there any question? Hello? Okay. So now we'll take the attendance. Roll number one.
Yes, sir, present.
Okay. Roll number two.
Yes, sir.